blessed morning, blessed morning, blessed morning.
I'm so grateful that I'm still standing tall. I thank you for my tears. The pain helped me overcome my fears.
Blessed morning, everyone. Blessed morning, people of God. Come on in, come on in. What a glorious day it is to be in the presence of the Lord, to be in the land of the living. God bless you, Sister Lisa. Thank you for joining this morning. As you begin to come in, please share, tag, like, invite someone on this morning to hear some morning encouragement that will help you get through your day, to help get you through your week. Oh, what a day it is, and what a joyful day it is to be in the presence of the Lord. Oh, I'm so grateful this morning. I'm thankful this morning. How many of you are thankful this morning that God brought you through it? He saw you through it. He's bringing you through it. Amen, amen, amen. I'm just thankful for it all, as the song says. All that we are is because of God who brought us through. Amen. So we give honor and glory to the Lord this morning. Bless you, Auntie Shelley. Thank you for watching. God bless you. I love you. God bless you, Sister Denise. Thank you for watching. I love you. Oh. We can't thank him enough this morning, people of God. Oh, for all the things that he has done, there are not enough thanks, there are not enough tongues we can speak in, there are not enough praises that we can give him, but we are just grateful this morning. We just have to pause and thank the Lord for what he has done. Just tell him thank you. Don't be like the nine lepers that went away after they received what they needed to receive from the Lord. But only one came back to say thank you. Be that one that says thank you this morning. Thank you for waking me up, Lord. Thank you for bringing me through my trials. Thank you for bringing me through my struggles. Thank you for helping me overcome adversity. Thank you, Jesus. We glorify the Lord this morning. God bless you, Auntie Sophie. Thank you for joining this morning. God bless you, Cousin Nikki. Thank you for joining this morning. Oh, I'm just thankful this morning. I don't know about you, but there's a praise on the inside of me because I have all the rest of my life to give him thanks, because if it had not been for the Lord who was on my side, where would I be? I would be laying in my grave right now. Amen. And I know that's some of y'all testimonies too. But glory to his name, glory for his mercies that are new in each and every day. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, we bless the name of the Lord this morning. Oh, God bless you, Cousin Stephanie. Thank you for joining. Oh, God bless you, Sister Lucy. Thank you for joining. Oh, God bless you, Sister Stephanie Freeman. Thank you for joining. Oh, we're thankful for the great and the small this morning. Amen. Even when we fail, the Lord brought us up and he's made us to stand tall. So we stand on his word this morning. It is his word that saw us through. It is his word that brought us through. And it's his word going to take you through continuously. Amen. That's why we continually speak the word of the Lord. We speak it to others. It's because of what he has brought us through. We did not do it on our own. It is all because of our Father.
I'm grateful for you.
How many are grateful this morning? Thank you, Jesus. Oh, I'm just grateful this morning. I'm just grateful for the Lord, for all that he has done and all the things he is about to do. God bless you, Brother James. Thank you for joining, great man, God. It was great seeing you at Singing Pastors. God bless you. Thank you for joining. As you come on, please share and like. Hit the thumbs up button. I'm just thankful this morning for what God is doing. I'm not going to be on here long this morning because I know everybody has to get their day going. But we just come on to give God some glory this morning. Amen. For waking us up, for breathing into us, for breathing on us this morning. Amen. Oh, because if it had not been for the Lord who was on our side. Hey, testimonies after testimonies. So we're just grateful and thankful this morning for what he is doing. How many know that God is getting ready to rearrange some things in your life? I'm here to tell you that the Lord dropped it in my spirit that he is getting ready to rearrange some things as we approach this year's end. Just know that God is getting ready to do some things. So there are some things that you've been praying about, some things that you've been hoping for, that you've been standing in faith for. And we know that sometimes standing in faith is not always easy when we don't see things. That's why we have to see beyond what we see. The word says that faith is the substance of the evidence. Faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. Amen. So we thank the Lord this morning that he's working everything out behind the scenes. We have enough faith to know that God will do it. Amen. Even if it doesn't come out how we thought it would come out. But we know that it is impossible to please God without faith. Amen. I was listening to Pastor Radford this morning and he was speaking about the same thing. It is our faith that pleases God. Would you rather please God or you just would you just rather see that thing happen? I know that's a hard place to be in. I was telling one of my aunts that last week as we prepared for the worst, but we hoped for the best. Before my uncle transitioned, we prayed, we stood in faith, but we also know that whatever the Lord does, it is still good. Amen. His will has to be done. And we know that he wants us to prosper. Amen. But also his will must be done. God is rearranging your destiny and he is working miracles in your life. Right in this very moment. Even things that we have never even thought of it or imagined that he would do. Amen. So I'm just grateful this morning. You know, there are some things that you've been praying for that just seems impossible. And God is telling you, it is your turn. I want somebody to write that in the messages. It's my turn. God is getting ready to do some things. He is getting ready to turn some things around. Because we know that all things work together for the good of those who love the Lord, who are called according to his purpose. And what the enemy meant for evil, God will turn it around for your good. Amen. For his word says, for I know the plans and the thoughts that I have towards you, and they are for good and not of evil. But that you should have what? Hope. Some versions say hope. Some versions say an expected end. And some say you should have a great future. Amen. So we thank the Lord this morning. We stand on his word. God will prove just how great he is in your life. And he's already proven how great he is in some of our lives. Amen. Because we're standing here today to talk about it. We're standing here today to speak and to declare the word of the Lord. We're speak to people to let them know God is in control. Amen. You know, the struggles of yesterday do not compare to the glory that God will reveal in you. I'm here to speak into your life this morning, into your situation, what the Lord has laid upon me this morning. We must declare God's word and his awesome possibilities. Amen. We will not count God out because God will never leave us nor forsake us, no matter how it looks, no matter how rough it gets. Amen. Amen. Yes, we are a witness to the things that God has done in our lives. That's why some of us need to be writing books Amen. The Lord is strengthening you in your mission. He is strengthening you in your weakness. Whatever that thing is that's been bothering you, the Lord is strengthening you. When we put our minds and our focus on God and not on the things that is around us and not on the things that we are going through, but we know that God will take us through and bring us out. Amen. That's the kind of faith that we have to have. That's the kind of faith we have to have. There's no better time than right now to do what God has called to do. I always say that there's no time like the right time, and the right time is now. Amen. Now is the time to do what God has called you to do. It's time to produce something great. No hesitations. We should always have an attitude of gratitude for what God has done, with expectation for what he is about to do. Amen. I'm just so grateful this morning. I am just so grateful this morning as I just begin to think on the goodness of the Lord and what he is doing. And there is no secret that what God can do. What he's done for others, he'll do for you. How many believe that this morning? Because I know this year has been a trying year. It's been one thing after the other. But through it all, we still give God glory. Amen. And the Lord says, there's, you know, whatever we bind on earth will be bound in heaven. And whatever you loose on earth will be loosed in heaven. So we have to know the words that we speak out of our mouths, the things that we want to see manifest in the natural. We have to start speaking those things. We have to start decreeing and declaring those things. Amen. We have to stay in the spirit and in the posture of God. We have to walk in it. We have to live in it. You know, like I said earlier, what the enemy meant for evil, God is going to use it for your good. He is getting ready to turn some things around. Oh, even when you thought that it was not going to happen. And that's the problem. We think everything is in our timing. No, it's all in God's timing. Amen. There is no life better than the one God has given you. Some people think that the grass is greener on the other side. No, you need to water your grass. Take care of what you have so you can see it prosper, so you can see it produce. Amen. You know, there's a river of miracles flowing to those who love God. There's all that you have needed, God has provided for you. He said, I will supply all your needs according to my riches and glory. He says, when you are faithful over a few things, God will make you rule over many things. So we have to remain in that posture. But even if he does not, we will not serve other gods. We will not worship idols. We will not do all these other things. We will not turn our face from God when we don't see things going our way. We will not be like the children of Israel. We will not get frustrated. We will not turn from God. Amen. Keep your eyes on the prize. I lift up my eyes to the hills from which cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord. Amen. That's what you need to tell yourself this morning. You need to speak the word of the Lord to keep your mind positive. God bless you, my beautiful wife. Thank you for joining. Pastor Yvette, thank you for joining this morning. I'm just grateful this morning, y'all. Because like I said before, God did it, but he didn't have to do it. He woke us up this morning with all use in our vital limbs. He breathed on us this morning. He breathed in us. I do not take it lightly. And I thank you all for just coming on. I just wanted to come on real quick this morning and just let you know that God is rearranging your destiny. He's still writing your story. His story. Amen. Because you're getting ready to go down in history. Some of your names getting ready to be engraved. It's getting ready to be stitched somewhere that someone cannot remove it. Even if they tried, you can still go back and see the engravings or the markings that was there. Nobody can't remove what God has allowed. Don't count yourselves out this morning, people of God. Just know God is working things out for you. May not be how you want it to be, but just know that God is doing it in your life this morning. Amen. I'm just grateful. I'm just full this morning. I pray that everyone has had a wonderful weekend. It's always a blessing and an honor just to come before you guys this morning. For those who may come on later and catch the replay, just know that God is rearranging some things. Keep pushing. Keep going. Don't stop. Him. Who's him? He is molding me. We pray. We prioritize righteousness around you. Hashtag, we're addicted to Jesus. S2P, the Lord wants your soul to prosper. We want your soul to prosper. That's why we come on to encourage you to keep going, to keep the faith. We stay ready so we don't have to get ready. We checking up the deuces to Satan. We tell him he got to go. He got to pack his bag. Evict him. He has no power and authority over you. That's why we have to stop allowing him in. Amen. Kick him out. Tell him you got to go. We're BAD. We're blessed and delivered. They play checkers. We play chess because we're strategic in how we serve the Lord. Amen. You got to be strategic about this wall. You got to be strategic in everything that you do. Do it with excellency. Amen. We're rocking with the best, J-E-S-U-S. We live a life of prosperity. Prosperity is our lifestyle. Amen. God bless you, Brother Marquis. Thank you for joining. We are restored. The Lord's getting ready to restore some things in your life. He's getting ready to turn it around. Amen. Tighten up. Pump your brakes. We know the race is not given to the swift nor to the strong. Use me, Lord, for your glory. You cannot be healed from what you do not reveal. You are what you answer to. You are a child of God. You are an heir to the throne. You are a lender and not a borrower. You are more than a conqueror. So just know, don't answer to anything other than what God has called you. Amen. We don't shake, we share. We're going up, people of God. We're going up, Lord. Says, come up hither. So we're going higher. We're going higher this morning. Declare it. Say, I'm going higher. I'm going higher in the things of God. I'm going where God has called me to go. I'm going to fly like the eagle this morning. Amen. Don't say it. Just pray it. Don't compromise who and what you are in Christ for anyone or anything. It is not worth it. We are here to please the Lord, not man. We are here to please the Lord. God gonna bring you out without a doubt. You have to know it. You have to feel that thing deep down on the inside of you, knowing that he's gonna do what he said he would do, because he is not a man that he should lie, nor the son of man that he should repent. His word should not return unto him void. Amen. He honors his word above his name. So you trust God when you can't even trace him. We will not bow to anyone or anything but Jesus. We will get over. I'm not living in the pandemic. I'm living in the shiftemic. Shift. Time to shift. I remember my first time driving a stick shift car. I'm like, what is this? I had to learn how to shift those gears to get to where I needed to go. You're going to have to learn how to shift some gears this morning to get where you need to go, where God has called you to be. Amen? Everything is not going to be so straightforward. No, you're going to have to learn how to shift some gears, shift some things around. You're going to have to learn some maneuvers. Amen? Like praising the Lord, because it confuses the enemy. We have to confuse the enemy. Stop going the same way all the time. Take a different route. Amen? So we stay ready, so we don't have to get ready. That should be your posture. Always be ready. Knowing, staying in your word. Stay in your lane. Your lane is God. God, I trust you. We all have our lane to be in. This is not a competition. It's not a race. Just do what God has called you to do. Amen. We are free worshipers. We will not be moved. You cannot evangelize and antagonize at the same time. And last but not least, we kingdom, baby. We're kingdom for life. We walk in kingdom mentality. We walk in kingdom principles. Amen. Knowing that God is who he say he is. Amen. He is Abba the Father. So we thank the Lord this morning. I thank the Lord for each and every one of you who have jumped on this live this morning. I pray as we approach this year's end, keep in your mind that God is getting ready to rearrange some things. He is getting ready to fulfill things that he has promised to you. Keep your faith. Keep the faith. Miracles are working in your favor, in your life, in the life of others. So just continuously pleasing God, whatever you do. Knowing that God will see you through. Amen. I just want to just bless the Lord. He said we should bless him at all times. Amen. There should come a continuous praise be in our mouths. He said let everything that hath breath praise the Lord. So I'm just grateful this morning. I praise the Lord for what he is doing. I give him honor. I give him glory. This through his holy magnificent name. So as you continuously move forward, you go with God, and God will certainly go with you. God will shine his face upon you and to get you where you need to go. Amen. He is your GPS. The Holy Spirit will lead you and guide you. Amen. Just allow him to. Be blessed, everyone. We love you. And don't forget to also check the page for updates on upcoming events. We're excited. We have the church launch coming up. I just want to remind everyone about that. And also, you know, visit our church on the app. It's Restoration at the Well. It's being posted in the comments. So just feel free to go view some of those past morning encouragements, because they will encourage you, because it will be a rhema word for what you're going through at that time. And they are always a blessing, because even I have to go back and rewatch some of those encouragements. Like David said, we have to encourage ourselves. Amen. So God bless you all. You all have a wonderful and blessed day, and we love you. Be blessed.